Well, this came up on the draw. Yeah, this is a great hand. I mean, it doesn't have any rituals, but it's got the Infernal Tutor. It's got Duress and Brainstorm, and all I gotta do is find some rituals. Birds of Paradise, alright? Some sort of Black Greed deck, I'm assuming. Do I want to play around a Wasteland? But I've got a basic Forest. Kinda don't think I do. I think I'd rather just Duress here. I feel like Duressing turn one is probably safer. Alright? Loxodon on Smiter, Scavenging Ooze. If I didn't have a Cabal Therapy, I could just name Smiter and then I'd have no problems at all. Scavenging Ooze is mildly annoying. I do have to watch out for that, since if I'm going to go for the Past in Flames victory, that is something that can get me. Probably turn 2, Brainstorm Pondering, and then Lumduel's Vaulting later. And I guess hoping my opponent doesn't draw any hate cards, if like a single Thalia or something, and I probably just lose, or Gaddock Teague. And I'm kind of glad my opponent played Scavenging Ooze here. That is the fear, that I would go off turn 2, so playing the Ooze makes that less likely. Alright, probably pretty sure I'm putting back lands here. Though maybe I should put back a Preordain instead of one of the lands. I mean, I could have probed first, or no, I drew the probe off the Brainstorm. Let's see. I can put back Swamp Delta and then crack Fetch. Yeah, that seems fine. I'll do that. So I'm going to crack my Fetch land. Just get another Underground Sea here. I'm going to probe my opponent. I assume seeing nothing too exciting. A Solid Pride Mage. Okay, so I'm not expecting any Duresses or anything like that. It looks like straight white-green. I am expecting potentially Thalia or Gaddock Teague, which I can't beat, so I'm on a little bit of a clock. Scavenging Ooze is mildly annoying, but I think I can live with it. Alright, let's go ahead and ponder. Alright, well, this is what I'm looking for, so let's do it this way so I don't get hit by Cabal Therapy. Not that I'm super worried about Cabal Therapy, but might as well. Now I kind of wish I'd kept the land over to Preordain here, but and I think Vault could be good if I have a little bit of time. I wouldn't mind trying to set up a Lumduel's Vault here. It's kind of hard to tell how much time I have. Like, clearly I'm not losing this instant, but if my opponent draws one of the hate cards, and I just straight up lose. All right, well, Marsh Flats is good to know. So if my opponent plays the way they have been with the Ooze, I'm expecting to see like a Quasali Pride Mage and an attack for 3 or something like that. Which again is not too much of a clock, but it does make it harder for me to like hit Threshold for Cabal Ritual. So the question is, do I want to try to go off this turn? I'm drawing a Cabal Ritual and there's an Infernal Tutor on top of my deck. Or do I want to wait? Let's see, what can I do? I have 1, 2, 3 with Lotus Petal, 5 with Dark Ritual, 6, 7 with Cabal Ritual. Unfortunately, Infernal Tutor doesn't actually get me anything, so I think I'm going to lead with Preordain, look for a land, and then play Lumduel's Vault end of turn. So I'm putting Infernal Tutor on the bottom, and putting Brainstorm on the top, and then giving up on the Lumduel's Vault plan for now, but I'm gonna, if I Brainstorm into a Fetch Lander, even if I don't, actually, I can still just cast... I think I can still cast Ad Nauseam this turn. Let's see, I have 5, I'm going to have 6 cards in my graveyard. Of 8, if I cast Dark Ritual Lotus Petal, and then I can, because I can put back here Duress and Cabal Therapy, or I guess I'll just put back Cabal Therapy and Lumduel's Vault, Duress my opponent. So 6, 7, 8 cards, 6, 7, 8, 9 cards, so my opponent can remove 2, but then I'll have 3, I'll have 5, 3 off Dark Ritual, go off, 4 off Lotus Petal, 3 off Duress, 1 off Cabal Ritual to 6, 4, 9. So that should be enough. Actually, I don't, but I do have to play the land. Alright, so let's put back Lumduel's Vault and Cabal Therapy, Swamp, Dark Ritual. Duress my opponent. Yep. Oh, there is a Swamp there, so... Alright, so we do eventually have to worry about black cards. Alright, let's play Lotus Petal. Let's cast Cabal Ritual, see if we can bait our opponent into using Scavenging Ooze to not give us Threshold. Alright, didn't even consider that. And let's cast Infernal Tutor. Storm count is 8. Oh, I don't even have to add Nizam or anything. I can just get Infernal Tutor and then Infernal Tutor and get Tendrils. And opponent can sack Pride Mage, go up to 18, but that doesn't do anything. Alright. Managed to get there. A little decent little brainstorm there. Alright. Tendrils of Agony, and Tendrils of Agony my opponent for 20 damage. It's a lot of damages. And that should be good. I mean, opponent can gain a life off sacking Pride Mage to kill Lotus Petal and oozing it. If I thought that was a problem, I could have just sacked Lotus Petal earlier, but obviously it doesn't matter here, so this should be fine. Alright, we're gonna go for it. And get some Lotus Petal action. Alright, I'll just let it die since it doesn't actually matter. That now I can F6. And going up to 17 to 18 doesn't actually change anything. Though my opponent did see it. There we go. And whoop, that should be it. So, sideboarding. Gaddock Teague is a card to worry about. It's one reason that Massacre's not just the best. My opponent's just chilling there for now, but I'm going to want Slaughter Pact and Massacres, and I could potentially bring in a Chain of Vapor. I do have slots here. That at least is nice. There's also Caracas, which I think it's the double duty, because against the mono white decks, you can bounce Thalia, and potentially out of this white-green deck, Gaddock Teague. Do want Massacres. Do want Slaughter Pact. Because I don't want Duresses. I could see playing like a Cabal Therapy or two in case my opponent leaves a card like Silence in. But certainly don't want Duresses. Could play Abrupt Decay. Or could play Chain of Vapor. I think I'd rather have Chain of Vapor. It's a little safer. And then this is leaving in two Cabal Therapies. One of the things I, again, don't like about this deck is that I have to side like that. Maybe Massacre's not great because of... maybe I'll just play two Chain of Vapors and one Massacre. Because Massacre is good against, like, Thalia, and Aether Sworn Canonist is not as good against Gaddock Teague, which I assume a white-green deck has access to, especially with something like Green Sun Zenith. I'll even one Massacre, though.